Hey, what's going on, traders? Welcome to this video. This is Chris from Brutal Trading. We're going to do a little video where I zip my t-shirt to start so I look more professional, and then let's start the video. So let's talk about technical analysis in this video. Okay, we're going to talk about a topic that is very relevant, very important, and I think that anybody who is new to trading should educate themselves on this topic as much as they possibly can and talk with some experienced traders who have studied traditional technical analysis, traders that have studied market profile, traders that have studied order flow trading, and all of the likes, so that you can get a good basis as to when these things become relevant in your trading, or if they're right for you or if they're not. So in this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over some knowledge I have and experiences that I've gained over time, and also some knowledge I've gained from other traders over time, just talking about things, learning about things, and also watching the markets, because at the end of the day, the market is always right. So the market will basically tell you if these things are true or not, if the market is respecting these areas or not, or are they totally arbitrary. Okay, now guys, remember to smash the like button and subscribe to the YouTube channel if you enjoy this type of content, because it really helps with that. And we've got a lot of content planned for the month of October here, so stay tuned. So make sure you hit that bell icon to get notified every time I place a video. Here we go. Okay, so from what I understand, traders often go through a very common pattern when they get into trading, and they seek out education. And this is what happens on the internet. If you search about trading, the first thing you're going to be directed to is technical analysis, and you're going to see some charts on the screen that look potentially similar to this and similar to that right there. And maybe you'll see, you know, a couple of lines on the chart, like a moving average or an RSI indicator attached to the chart. This is what could be considered traditional or classical form of technical analysis. Now, when a new trader is learning about trading, they are making the connection between trading and these lines on the graph that they are seeing. So therefore, what they're learning is that they need to become better at reading these lines, these candlesticks, in order to become better at trading. Now, I'm here to tell you guys that that is 100% false, and that you will not become a profitable trader simply by becoming a master of technical analysis. And this is why. Because an analyst and a trader are two different things. And any trader will tell you the same thing. The job of an analyst is to know the levels, tell you all the levels, where they all are on the order book, on all different time frames. The job of a trader is to essentially be physically and mentally fit to execute their trade on a consistent basis and make sure that they're in shape to do that execution every single day. What I want to talk about in this video is I want to discuss some of the common myths and things that people say about technical analysis out there. Now, what I've learned in my time of trading and learning about trading, I've been trading since the third quarter of 2018, pretty much nonstop since then. I've learned a lot over this time. What I've learned is that there are some traders that swear by technical analysis, and they swear by certain aspects of technical analysis. And then on the other side of the baton, there are some traders that say technical analysis and market structure and market context is absolutely, totally bullshit, 100% garbage. So like, this is really interesting, because there are people out there trying to sell you stuff saying that technical analysis is totally bullshit. And then there are people out there trying to sell you stuff saying that technical analysis is going to make you a better trader. So which one is telling the truth? So that's pretty much what it is. This whole industry of trading stocks and futures is very, very interesting, and you really need to be careful who you listen to, including anybody on YouTube. Take everything you hear with a grain of salt. I always repeat this to traders, okay? Just because you're listening to a guy talk with a bunch of fancy charts on his screen, he's talking about why Bitcoin's going to 100,000 or why AMC is going to pop, you should not believe a word that comes out of his mouth, and you should definitely not put your money where his mouth is. You should put your money where your mouth is, for that matter. Okay, so let's get to what I think of technical analysis and how I use it and how I have used it in my trading journey. So when I first got into trading, I was watching a YouTube channel known as The Chart Guys. You might have heard of them. And This is some very good content if you are new to markets, if you're new to technical analysis, and you want to learn a little bit more about how to understand market structure. Or is it? Now, here's where it gets a little complicated. Okay, so a lot of traders believe that when they look at a chart on the screen, that support and resistance is the high of a bar or a movement in the market, or the low of a movement in the market. So if we briefly watch this analyst here, he is pointing to an area of previous support, and you can see that he has placed his line here right on the lowest tick of these bars right here, and this is a daily time frame. Okay, so I've seen hundreds and hundreds of traders do this. They put their support and resistance lines basically where the low tick of the bar is, or the high tick of the bar, and they say that's the support and that's the resistance. And that right there, I can tell you from experience, is 100% false, 100% a lie. And I'll tell you why. I'll explain it to you right now. So when you look at a chart, it doesn't matter what time frame it is on. It could be on a 1 minute, it could be on a 15 minute. Let's look at, for example, a 15 minute time frame. Let's look at this movement down right here. And some traders would look at this and they would say, okay, at the bottom of this move, that's the support. Okay, why do you categorize this as support? Okay, so we're gonna get into some market technicals here and market fundamentals, basically. So what moves a market? It's supply and demand. It is liquidity. So what you're seeing on this price graph here is market movement that has already occurred. And how this market has moved is through orders trading into the market. Buy orders and sell orders, supply and demand. Now, what this chart is telling us is it's giving us a simplified picture of this exchange of supply and demand, which is why placing arbitrary lines at random areas on your chart, including the lowest tick of a bar or the highest tick of a bar, in reality is not any relevant information to the market, because it's not telling you about how the market moved from there to there. You did not see how that happened. And again, that's why you need to understand the purpose of technical analysis. In my opinion, it is for market context, understanding market structure and market context. So in this video, we're trying to learn about technical analysis, the pros and the cons of it, that people trying to sell you technical analysis will not tell you, and people trying to tell you technical analysis is bullshit, they're not going to tell you why it's actually helpful. In this video, I'm trying to explore both sides. Okay, so like I just finished telling you, the lows and the highs of bars are not necessarily support and resistance. That's totally a myth, okay? Just because the market stopped here, it doesn't mean that that's where the buyers came in to support the price. It just means that that's where the market stopped. And it just so happens that in the greater context, that ended up being the low right there. In fact, it was an unfair low. It was a price that is, in fact, not important at all and will not be important going forward. So if the market drops next week and then trades this price, if you think that this price is support, well, you are gravely mistaken, because it is not support at all. Here's how I would use this chart right here. So I look at the market from the perspective of what moves the market, which is supply and demand. I will place a zone on the chart when I can see that the market participants have now created an imbalance, right? So in this case, we have had a movement down, and then we have finally seen the bulls take control of the market. The first time we saw a bull bar close below the high of the previous bar, in this case, that was right there. So I've marked in the zone starting from this area right here, 14,582.25. Now, this price is not an absolute price. I will not trade based on this price. It is simply an area of context that has been given to me by the market. The market participants have demanded the market. They have created an imbalance in the marketplace, and this is the area of context where they have created this imbalance. In this case, it's a demand. So I call this a demand zone. Like I just finished telling you, I do not trade off of that zone. However, based on how the market is trading, I'm getting confirmation from the order flow of the market. I can get a better idea of which side of the market I need to be favoring. Okay, that's as simple as I can explain it. So a lot of traders will look at a chart and they're gonna outline things like this. That's the support right there. That's the resistance right there. But like I just finished telling you, markets don't work that way. They just don't stop at a price and then that's the support. In fact, the price that they ended up stopping at was just an exhaustion area. It is not the actual area where business was being conducted that lifted the market or sold the market down, AKA the area of supply or demand. So that is why I believe that highs and lows of bars are not support and resistance. It's simply for that reason. And if you're a retail trader and if you believed prior to this video that highs and lows of bars are support and resistance, then you might have learned something new today. You might feel a bit uneasy. You might say, wow, I feel weird because this guy is telling me something that I thought was true, but now it's not true according to what this guy is saying. And that's why you should never believe what anybody tells you. You should always do your own homework and watch the market, because the market will tell you the truth. The market is the number one truth. And again, so if I was looking at this chart, where I would put the supply and demand zone is the first one I would put right above the high of this bar right here, because we can finally see at this point that the bulls have taken control in this area right here. Now, this is a monthly chart, okay? And I'm gonna be honest with you, the way I use this method of identifying supply and demand zones is normally to be used on a 30-minute or 15-minute chart. It can also be used on a 5-minute chart when 15-minute chart is not clear. And it can be used on a daily chart as well. That's it. I just wanted to debunk that myth. Okay, trend lines. One of the most arbitrary things in all of trading. Whenever you see a person showing you a chart like this with a line on it like that, you should always tell them to go, you know what I mean? Get the hell out of here, bro, because you don't know what you're talking about. Basically, what they've done is they have created a line that has connected multiple pivots, normally in an ascending or descending formation because it's supposed to be a trend. And it is now indicating that, look, he's put a question mark right here, showing that this right here could be support for the market. But let me ask you one thing. How can this be support for the market? If you look at the prior price action, when the market prior traded in this area, okay, there was no imbalance of the supply and the demand. In fact, the imbalance was more around this area right here. It was more around that 14,000 area. You can see that that was an area where there was a supply and demand battle before the market continued to move through this entire area. So this trader is highlighting this zone right here. In fact, they are off in this analysis. I'm gonna show you what my daily chart looks like. I'm gonna show you my way of identifying supply and demand zones. It does not rely on arbitrary concepts like trend lines, okay? Just because you drew a line there doesn't mean that that's support or resistance. Even if it's a line on a multi-yearly, monthly, daily time frame. In fact, I would say the larger the time frame, the less relevant it is. But again, someone might be able to correct me there. I'm not a monthly analyst. I'm a trader that trades on an intraday basis. I scalp for your stop loss. So let's look at this daily chart. We can see a few clear levels. And as I was previously discussing to you, this is an area of context right here on the daily chart of the NASDAQ. And it could be also be extended to right here. So we have this area right here, 950-275 to 14,095.75. How I got these zones, I'll explain it to you right now. Look at this movement up in the marketplace right here, a movement up. The first time we saw a close below the low of a previous bar was right here at 952.75. So I marked that in. So that's an area to be watching. Now on the way up here, the market did some other stuff. We can mark in zones here, but that's not what I'm trying to focus on. In this area right here, again, we can see a movement up. And then we have some two-way trading. We have two bear bars in a row followed by one bull bar closing above the high here. And that is giving us a battle zone. Now, you can clearly see it in this area, how the market has respected this area and it came back to test the previous battle zone before moving up. And again, I always gotta remind you guys, I do not make trades off of these lines. I simply use them as ways to see the market structure and then go and look at the order flow to confirm how the market participants are conducting business around these areas of market structure, market context. So this whole low volume area, in the context that we're currently in, if we stay below 682.5 on the NASDAQ at this current moment, there is a chance that we can continue to see some lower rotations into these low volume areas here. So that's kind of how I identify market context. So the question of this video becomes, is technical analysis reliable? Well, reliable for what exactly? Reliable to make trades off of a line on a chart? I would say no, it's not reliable to make trades off of if all you're doing is drawing a line on a chart and then looking at how a candlestick forms. I would say it's not reliable. I personally want to look at how the market is trading, and I want to look at imbalances of supply and demand. I want to see where aggressive participants are lifting the offers or hitting the bids, and where they're being right and where they're being wrong in certain areas. I want to see where passive participants are potentially absorbing size of aggressive participants, and I want to see overall how market participants are trading around areas of market context. So this brings me to the conclusion. Some traders out there will claim technical analysis is 100% bullshit. Market context is 100% an illusion. Market makers do not use technical analysis. They do not use levels like this. They only use pure supply and demand. Other traders will say technical analysis is the holy grail. They can talk to you about patterns like bull flags, like 50% Fibonacci retracements, and how all of these things can tell you where you should be trading and why you should be trading off of these arbitrary levels. In my opinion, I'm somewhere in the middle. I do believe that having some sort of understanding of the market structure and the market context is beneficial if you're able to use it only as market context, and then use the order flow and the true supply and demand of the market to confirm how traders are participating around these areas of market context. So that's where I stand in regards to that. Again, be careful when people tell you things like technical analysis is total bullshit or technical analysis is the only thing you need for trading. And that's it. So that's going to be the end of this presentation. If you enjoyed it, leave a like on the video. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. I'll catch you soon. All the best. Take care.